Hey guys, what's up? How are you? I'm doing so well. So well. Anyway, now that I've got that shit out of the way, it is 5 o'clock in the morning, exactly 5 o'clock, October 2nd of 2012, and since it is the beginning of the next month, I should do a September favorites video, because that's what, you know, I'm supposed to do. Well, I feel compelled to do it. I really don't have to, but I do it anyway, because I know people like favorites videos, and whether it gets viewed or not, I don't care. I do it because I like it, so. My eyeshadow look is something that is amazing and awesome, and I love it a lot. And it's with something that actually is in my favorites, because I've done this look a couple times in the month. Sometimes I wasn't wearing makeup because I was cleansing my skin and shit, and I didn't want makeup on it, so there was days that I went without wearing makeup and things like that, or anything on my face, except like maybe moisturizer, if that. But, and even then, I'd wash that off and just basically do sulfur masks, all kinds of shit. But anyway, that's later in the video. I'm gonna start with just basic, like, general face, lips and eye makeup thing stuff. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna start with foundations. That came out 12 times better. Anyway. Foundations. Okay, so I haven't used many concealers this month, if not any, at all. Like, I use the NYC one if I have a kind of bad breakout, but that one doesn't have really buildable coverage to it, so it's a little useless. But, there are two foundations that you can either use separately or together, because one's a tiny bit thinner than the other one, but they have similar coverage. Is this roll-on photo ready airbrush. I've showed this in one of the last fucking three videos that I've made, and it's in 10 vanilla. It's I think the lightest one. It comes out like a mousse. It does have a lot of glitter in it. It's only noticeable if you really put it on your hand, or if someone is like, if this is someone's face and they're right here, that's the only way that they'll be able to see the glitter, really. But, this is also kind of like a ranting, rambly thing, because, I watch a few videos here and there, and, of, a lot of different YouTube users that do, like, kind of like coffee talk things, and since I don't have a monster, because I was going to do start a thing where I just kind of ramble on about things and my opinion on things and just certain things in my life that are, I guess, relevant. There's Wildwood Claire that does the coffee time things. Mr. Repsion does the coffee time things. And those I always find entertaining, because my everyday life stories are half-ass amusing. So, I mean, there's more people that do things like that, but I was going to start it only with energy drinks, because I really don't drink coffee that much, but I need it this morning so I can actually do this fucking video, because I won't want to do it later. So, makeup on, I look good. I think I look good. I'm going with it. And my hair is just like this. It was in a messy bun thing in the back of my head, and a big knot in a fucking hairband. So it's kind of like really dingy looking. Like I was gonna straighten it, but I didn't. But anyway, foundation. The other foundation that I typically use, that I normally pretty much always use, as of the past 3 or 4 months, maybe, if that. Probably I started doing this or wearing this in May or June, and it's the Revlon Color Stay Whipped Cream Makeup. I would like to try the Revlon, just regular Revlon Color Stay, just to see how that is, because I do have moderate acne, not severe acne, but it's moderate, it's kind of up here, it's most commonly down there, and yes, I'm touching it, so I'm probably just making it worse, but, anyway. I need to sit differently, because this shit's hurting my back. Okay. Okay. I feel like a midget now, because I just shrunk myself, so I look short. Anyway. Foundations. This one, people have compared it to the Maybelline, the fuck, Dream Aerofoam Mousse shit. Like, my sister has it. It's terrible. No. Just no. Absolutely not. Which, it could be, she may have got the wrong color, it could be anything, but even if the formula is so runny and nasty, you can hear McLovin kind of running in the background. McLovin is my little Olympic runner. But, use this first, if, like, my acne is just not having it that day, just, put face primer on first, which, I might want to mention this before anything. It's the Rimmel Fix and Perfect Foundation Primer 001, which is just, like, a peachy-toned primer that goes over your face that almost has some kind of awkward sheer coverage, and I don't know. But, and then you put this on, and then you put this on over this, and then it's like, boom, airbrush, flawless, amazing. But if you don't want to pack your face with foundation, which it's not really even heavy, this alone is not heavy. The packaging is heavy, but it itself is not heavy. It's a really pudding-like texture. And as this is light as all hell. Even on your skin, it's so light. The only downfall that other people may have with this is that it is a little glittery, but whatever. But this has no glitter in it whatsoever. None. Like, just none. Look at that. No glitter. Look at that. Yeah. I keep using it a lot. This is my second jar because I had to repurchase it because, you know. I think I made a Target haul not too long ago where I had to, or some kind of, some haul video. Was it Walmart? I don't even know if I made a fucking video. I think I did. I think it was Walmart. I got this on Walmart. The first time I bought it, I was at Target. That was on Target haul back in May or June. You can look back at my videos and go, ah, crazy bitch, but, I don't care. One of the other things that I'd like to mention in this video is, an eyelid primer or eye primer or whatever by Mary Kay. It's the Mary Kay Signature Eye Primer that works kind of very similar to the Urban Decay Primer Potion, but I find that this one is a little bit more, it's like a weird tacky feeling. It's not like, it's not really liquidy, but it's not really, like, thick and whatever. I can't find the words. I'm just babbling about nothing. But anyway. Oh my god, it's already 9 minutes in and I haven't even dented into anything. But anyway, yeah, this is really good. Works just as good as the Urban Decay, but it does have a tiny bit of a different texture. So if you're used to the Urban Decay, and you'll notice that one feels a little heavier, which is kind of weird, because it's a primer, it's not supposed to really feel heavy at all, but it is. I don't know why. And a blush that I've used, I think I mentioned this in one of my last 3 month favorite video, that was a few videos ago. It's the You by Ungaro, or Ungaro. It's face powder, but I used it as blush. And it's in champagne with a red lid. Looks like that. It's got like this weird brick red kind of thing in the middle. And then on the outer part, it's a very pretty peachy apricot-y, whatever color. I don't know. It's kind of tan, so I think it looks pretty good. It's not bad. Something that I rediscovered, I was using this e.l.f. cream triangle thing of liquid highlight, whatever. And I found this within my thing of makeup, and it's the Maybelline Lunar Energy Super Lasting Liquid Shimmer for a Luminous Look. And it doesn't have a number or anything. It's just like the pink one. I don't even think that they sell it in stores because I bought mine at Dollar Tree at least a year or so ago, if not more. I don't quite remember, but I bought it at Dollar Tree. That's all I know. And it was last year sometime. And it was... There's a little bit of a difference between the e.l.f. one, which I can fucking show you guys the e.l.f. one. It's the e.l.f. Shimmer Facial Whip and Lilac Petal. Looks very... the pinky peach kind of color. This one is a lot more shimmery and glittery. Like, you'd expect, highlight. This one highlights. This one is like putting fucking glitter, just smearing it on your face. Like, you're fucking Kesha or something. And I don't feel like being Kesha every day of my life. Fuck that. No. Anyway. Onto three eyeshadow things that I've just used absolutely nonstop all the time. And then I have a palette, which is one of the only palettes that I have. But here's a quad palette. What, I don't know what this is classified as, but it is a little eyeshadow palette, I guess. I don't know. It's got six really small eyeshadows in it by LA Colors, and it's one of their bold eyes eyeshadow quad palette things in CP123 Striking. Striking. It comes with a little ghetto sponge tip applicator, which is only good in the cases where you don't have a brush or something. If you have a brush, use it. But these are really good pigmentation. My favorites have to be the brown and the black. I like the other ones too. The one that looks red is really, really pink. I thought it was red at first when I looked at it, and I was like, oh, yay, I'm all excited. And then it was pink. I'm like, awesome. It's fucking pink. It's brilliant. But, yeah. That's a really good thing to have. The quality's great. It has great staying power with an eye primer. I don't use it without an eye primer. I don't put any eyeshadow on without an eye primer because I don't want to take the risk of it creasing and getting all weird if I'm out somewhere or doing something. And I just want my shit to look good, and I want to make sure, damn sure, that it's going to look good. And I don't want to risk it, so I just put eye primer on. So, not to deal with that. But, here's something that I wore nonstop for quite a while in the past couple months. Is the Revlon Satin Eyeshadow. And it's one of the Revlon Luxurious Color Satin Eyeshadows. In number 20, Nude Slip. Has a little sponge tip applicator, which actually is a little bit more helpful than any other cheapo one. And it's just a really pretty nude color. Very bronzy and kind of, not glittery, but it's more shimmery. Which reminds me, I'm going to touch on the concept of shimmery and glittery. Because I know a lot of people are like, oh, it's so glittery, or oh, it's so shimmery, and it's like the opposite. Like, glittery is thick glitter. Glitter, glitter, glitter. Shimmer is like tiny, 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 tiny sparkles. Glitter is like fucking what Kesha fucking smears on her face. It's like that e.l.f. shit. Like shimmer. Oh yeah, that's nice and shimmery. Like, I'll swatch something. I'll swatch the Revlon Nude Slip on my hand. Because this has a shimmer quality to it. God damn it. I put it in the most stupid fucking spot, but But it does have a shimmer quality to it. Now, I'm just going to pull something random from my makeup power of terror. Like this hard candy iDef thing and sprinkles. It's a liquid eyeshadow kind of concept. This is the first thing I could see up there that's glittery. See, when you initially put it on your hand, you see the outrageous. Let's see if I can. There's an outrageous amount of glitter, and if I try to blend it out. In fact, the problem with this particular one is it's very chunky glitter. And you see the nude slip is still intact, still basically doing what it's doing. That's the difference between shimmer and glitter to me. Shimmer is very fine radiance. But glitter is like chunky, big pieces of glitter. That's what glittery means to me. I don't know. I mean, this could be different for everybody. I know no one probably fucking cares. But that's just kind of what I think. Next thing, moving on, is one of the Hard Candy Kaleidoscope Baked Eyeshadow Duos, number 61, Blind Date, which I've mentioned this one a few times before, but, you know, it's whatever. And it's half really pretty pink, half like a shimmery... No, fuck that, that's glitter. That's glitter. I'm dumb. I just stared down at it. Because I got this shit in my eye earlier, and it kind of hurt. Because I had to take the contact out of this eye and then leave it in this one. But I just had to do that thing when I was applying it to this eye because it felt stupid. But very, 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 very shimmery, glittery, whatever. Because I can't tell because there's small pieces of shimmer, but there's giant chunks of glitter. So it's a mix of the two. But that's very good quality. They're only $6 a piece. And these are like palm to this ratio. It's a pretty decent size for an eyeshadow, and it's baked, so it's domed, so it's kind of like a flat surface like that, only minus the knuckles and hands. An eyeliner, a lot of eyeliners that I've been using. Well, first let me, eyeliners, then eyebrow, then another eye primer that I, dumb and I forgot. An eyeliner that I just bought at Big Lots, like, a week and a half ago, is the Revlon, Luxurious Color Smoky Crayon in number 8, Steel Smoke. This actually comes off looking very, very kind of charcoaly, almost black. It looks very similar to something that CoverGirl would probably make as like a cream eyeshadow stick. But it's an eyeliner or an eye crayon, so I guess you could use it for anything. But I personally use it for my waterline, and it stays so good. Seriously, so good. I like it a lot. And another thing that is a twisty stick eyeliner that I've used for about almost a year now is the Maybelline Unstoppable retractable eyeliner in Onyx. So it looks like this. A lot of the stuff that I use, I just signed up not too long ago for a Makeup Bee account. But I think it's, hold on, let me look. MakeupBee.com. And the thing on there is Alyssa S. If I can, I'm sure you could find me. It's not rocket science. But, I have a few certain looks that I've done or just fucked around with and came up with. Really, most of them have been like, oh, well, I'm just gonna do this and hope it looks good. Not really inspired by anything except the Sammy Jane one, which was obviously Sammy Jane inspired, not expired, because I can't talk. Retractable eyeliner. This shit stays so good. So good. And, yeah. I'm starting to think the coffee was a bad idea, because now I'm all like, ah, I just want to run into the... Ah. That was mind-numbing, I apologize. Anyway. Another thing. The last eyeliner thing. Related thing. That I've used a lot since I bought it a couple of weeks ago. Is the Rimmel Scandalized Waterproof Gel Liner in number 1 black. And it looks like that. It's got a little jar at the bottom. A little 0.07 ounce jar thing. There's like 2 grams of product in it. The cap twists off from there. Exposes the tiny little jar. Looks like that, right? You know, usual whatever. And then this pops out and it's a little mini brush. Hold it against my forehead because you can see it. My forehead is the same fucking color as my hand. But I really like the concept of this packaging because it... Okay, with the Maybelline Master Drama gel liner, it comes with a little brush, but it doesn't have it where it won't make a big fucking mess if you take it somewhere to do your makeup or whatever. Because that black shit from the brush for the Maybelline Master Drama Blackest Black stuff just fucking gets all over everything, and I get mad because I'm like, okay, now there's eyeliner all over my important shit. It needs to, like, stop that and whatever. But solution for that, plastic bag. But that plastic bag will get dirty, so you'll have to replace it. So buy a box of fucking 40 of them from Walmart for $4 and you're good. My eyebrows, as of lately, I've used this Wet n Wild Color Icon brow / eyeliner. You can use it for anything, because that's what it says. And the number is 652, and it's dark brown, which works just as good as the Rimmel pencil. The reason that I originally did not get the Rimmel pencil, well, I repurchased it anyway, is because the first one I bought was, I bought it at Ulta. Ulta is relatively far from my house, so it takes a lot of effort to go from one place to another, and gas and blah, and my mom will bitch about it. So anyway, went to Walmart. Walmart didn't have shit. And went to Kmart, and Kmart had stuff. So I'm like, okay, Kmart, you're awesome. So now I have this, and this is 99 cents, so you can't go fucking wrong, or $1.98, depending on where you get it. The price will vary. But they are very good quality. I've used the black one and a charcoal one as an eyeliner. Very good. Very good quality. I really like them. And anyway, the other eyelid primer that I use is the e.l.f. Dollar Eyelid Primer. I have 2 of these. This is my second one. My third one is sitting over there. I kind of switched between the 2 of them. I don't know why, because they both, I guess, look the same, and I don't know which one I'm using up more, but I guess that really doesn't matter. But they are extremely similar to Urban Decay and the Mary Kay. They're just very sheer, and they kind of blend right in with your skin tone. Right when you initially put the product on your skin, and you blend it in your eye area, eyelid, wherever you're blending it at, what it does is it'll just sheer out and make you look like you almost put nothing on. And it works just the same as something that's fucking $20 for a giant tube, which I would buy, because I'm a fucking sucker for Urban Decay, because I like their stuff, because it's good. But it works just as good, and it's a fucking dollar. My only questionable thing about this is the packaging is a little confusing. Because I don't know if any of you remember when Urban Decay had their primer potions in, like, a dope butt applicator kind of form, where it just kind of ploops in the fucking thing and does stuff, and you can't really get any product off the walls. Just when it runs out, and you're fucked. And, you know, this is a little bit harder plastic, so it's a little harder to cut open, but if you really wanted to cut it open, you could. Make it, scrape it out, whatever. Do what you do with the Urban Decay Primer Potion. Very similar concept. Which makes me wonder if they were just doing it just for giggles and shits, but, you know, whatever. But there's so little product in here. But it's a dollar, so, I mean, you can't go wrong either way. So it never hurts to try that. And mascaras, I use between 4 of them, but I'm going to list 3. Well, I guess I can list 4. I'll list 4. Fuck. 2 CoverGirl ones and 2 Maybelline ones. Which, ironically, oh, multicoloredness. Look at it. Yeah. We'll start with the CoverGirl. Both, I got Big Lots. They were $1.50 a piece. That's fucking amazing. Like, my mind is blowing in 50 fucking directions because they were $1.50 a piece. That makes me ecstatic. That's why I have 2. One is a Lash Blast Volume by CoverGirl, and one is Lash Blast Luxe, which both work very similar. Just kind of strange, but, you know, it's whatever. They have very thick brushes. They're very, very similar to the Physician's Formula, if you've ever used that. But they're still, nonetheless, very volumizing. It's kind of like the falsies and the 1x1 combined in one tube. Each of them are basically the same thing. It really doesn't matter. They're like the same fucking thing in each tube, so it doesn't really matter. Now here, I have Maybelline's falsies, and 1x1. 1x1 is one of the first Maybelline mascaras that I've ever owned. I got it for last Christmas. There's a video on that as well, and the shit that I got for Christmas, which includes this and a little retractable eyeliner in Onyx, the Maybelline Unstoppable one. Use that up, and that is actually the one I showed a few minutes ago, 10 minutes ago, I don't know. That one is my second one, just like this is my second bottle of the 1x1. Which is one of the best mascaras that I've used because it's really good at separating. But the falsies, Frank Caitlin got this for me. Both are in blackest black. I don't get my mascaras in any other color but black, typically, if I'm trying them out and trying to figure out what I like and what I don't. Color would be just for fun, I guess, but whatever. But the falsies is absolutely excellent for volumizing. No shit. And making you look like you actually fucking have lashes. For those that have short lashes. Like on this side of my eye, I have short eyelashes. This side of my eye, they're long. I don't understand. I will never understand. I don't care. But both are very good mascaras. They're like $5 or $6 a piece, give or take, depending on where you buy them. But it's kind of worth it because it's like, oh, nice. They're good. But if you want both of those in one big giant tube, just get Lash Blast whatever. Lash Blast Volume or Lash Blast Luxe. So, it doesn't really matter which one. And I have several, quite literally, several, 7 lip products to show you. Start off with my favorite thing that I own. One of the only MAC lipsticks that I own, and it's the MAC Viva Glam Gaga 2, which is the nude colored one for all skin tones. As you can see, I've used quite a bit of it. I use it quite frequently because I like doing darker looks on my eyes. So I kind of need something to contrast it, so I just use this. But they don't make this anymore, so I'm fucked if I run out. But it is absolutely one of my favorite fucking things that I've ever owned by MAC, which, when I get paid, I will be sure to, I get paid monthly, so, I mean, whenever I say, whenever I get paid, and whenever I get to go to the mall and places that I need to get get to and go to and whatnot. I'll be sure to pick up more Mac things, because they are relatively expensive, but, you know, it's cool. I got nothing else to fucking spend shit on, so, I mean, a few things, but not anything that important. Not that important. One of the next things is a Revlon lipstick in, Revlon Super Lustrous lipstick. And 631 Luminous Pink, and it's a pearl, pearly lipstick. Very, 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 very pink. And it almost is like, it is right there. I don't know, it's very pearly, it's very pink, it's very pretty, and I do like it a lot. It's good with almost any look except teal, because it looks a little weird with teal. Most pinks do, but, well, ow, I don't know, it's burped, and it kind of hurt. And I just knocked things down. Nice. Anyway, L'Oreal lipstick that I got not too long ago, and it's one of the L'Oreal Colorish lipsticks, and 184 Merino Mauve, and it's honestly, because I mean, the packaging looks like this, and I think this is relatively new, I suppose. Looks like that in the tube. I have fucking eyeliner on my hands. That's fantastic. It's more of a, like a less shimmery version of the Revlon lipstick that I just showed. It's top one. No. Yeah, it's top one. I'm done. I put them in the dumbest fucking places. It's the one right here. It's more of a muted down version of the Revlon Luminous Pink. It's kind of nice, but, you know, whatever. And there's two Revlon lip butters that I've consistently used the past few months that I've had them. And one is in number 5, Sugar Frosting, and these are the Color Burst lip butters. If you do not know what they are, they have the consistency of a lip balm, but have sort of the pigmentation of a lipstick, kind of. They're very, 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 very pretty. The reason they have dents is because, well, I have metal in my face, and sometimes when I'm putting them on, they'll accidentally hit one of my lip rings or something and put a little tiny dent in them, but I end up smoothing it out eventually, but, you know, whatever. These are really good. Absolutely wonderful. They are $6 or $7 a piece, depending on where you buy them at. But, I have 3 of them. The other one's Creme Brulee up there. I don't use that one as much because it's a nude. Sometimes I don't want nude stuff all the time, and I want different colors. And then this one is number 55, Cupcake. Cupcake is a brighter pink, in which I've used a little bit more of. And it's quite literally that really, really bright pink. And most of my lip products have dents in them because of my lip rings. So if you see more of those dents, I wouldn't be surprised. And the last two lip things that I'm showing you are two of the L'Oreal Colorish Balms with SPF 15. And one is in Caring Coral. Number 418, Caring Coral, very obvious pink color, very pretty. These aren't really pigmented, but I really didn't want them to be pigmented, because they're just something that you can throw on with almost anything and then look just as good as ever. So I'm trying to put some of this stuff up so it's not as cluttered all up in my business. Well, I don't know what I'm doing. Anyway. And then the other one is Caramel Comfort number 819. This one, just a nude color, very similar to the Creme Brulee Lip Butter. It's a very brownish nude color, very pretty. Again, very sheer and whatnot. Now that's pretty much it for the makeup. I forgot to mention a palette, and I'm dumb because they're sitting behind everything. But I've been using a few colors out of my Urban Decay Mariposa palette, the metal one with the butterfly on it. I'll point out the colors real quick, and then I'll move on to hair. Whenever I actually do my hair. I've been using Infamous, Wreckage, Mushroom, and Height, and Spotlight. So, I mean, you could pretty much figure out which ones that I like, judging by what the names I just said. Height is the really pretty aqua blue one. Mushroom is the brownish one that looks like it has a giant dent in it. Spotlight's really good for on top of Mushroom. Infamous is just fucking pretty. Wreckage is good for on top of Mushroom as well, or just a good standalone color. And then Gunmetal is a really pretty crease color, because it's got that dark charcoal aspect to it, so it looks really, really good. As one of those corner things, and smoky eye and whatnot. Anyway, on to the hair things. I've been using the Beyond the Zone Pro Formula Rock On Dry Shampoo by the people that do shit at Sally's that is Beyond the Zone. Because that's where I got this, and I got it for $6.79. I got this a few months ago, but I use dry shampoo because it's not healthy to wash your hair every single day. Wash it every other day, and so the oils can build up, whatnot, and do what they do. But not only does it smell really good, it makes your hair look really good, and I personally like it. When I get paid, I'm going to get a couple more different dry shampoos, probably from Ulta and or Sally's. So, be on the lookout for videos like that too, which will probably end up being a haul video first, and then later on reviews, because I'm planning on doing more review things too. It'll be a big fiasco of videos, so, yeah. The other thing I've been using, after I get out of the bathtub, and I put this, my hair on dry, put clothes on and whatever, my hair's still wet, damp, whatever, I put the Got To Be Smooth Operator Smoothing Luxury Mousse, and it kind of helps not make my hair a poopy, frizzy, dingy fucking mess. Very good stuff. I really like how the packaging looks. Granted, I'm not a complete sucker for packaging and coloring and whatnot, but it does look pretty cool. And it smells really good, too. That's the thing with a lot of the Got To Be stuff, is it does smell really, really, really good. The next thing I have is Got To Be Smooth Operator with Cashmere's Smoothing Satin Drops, which also help with shine, making your hair smell fucking amazing, and kind of defrizzing and de-poofing your hair. Mainly, the smell is what really, like, the first thing that grabs your attention, because when you pump it out, it comes out like a tiny little thing of oil. It's just a tad little drop, and then it's got little glitters in it that when you put it, your best bet is to put two on your fingers, just on the tips of your fingers, and then run it through your hair. I don't want to run through my hair right now, because my hair is kind of a fucking mess, but you always do that when it's wet, because when it's wet and it'll dry, the product will kind of go with it and whatever. If you put it on it when it's dry, it'll look like you dipped your head in fucking vegetable oil, and it will look really gross. But other than that, it smells really good, and it helps with the frizziness and the craziness that is my Chewbacca pube-looking hair. So, there's a few body sprays that I've been using, but this one is the one I kept in my purse the most. I've had it for quite a while. It's dwindling down to its final days. I've probably got like a third of it left, almost. And it's the pink with the splash, pretty and pure. The one with like the tealy green, bluish lid. It smells very, very, very nice. Very fresh, clean scent with kind of a florally, fruity, weird kind of combination that I just somehow really like. Really draws me in. But, anywho, way, what, why, when, and how. Let me grab a couple more fucking sprays that I somehow neglected to grab. Because I'm terrible at life, apparently. Oh, fucking shit. Damn it, everything. Okay. Oh no, I keep fucking dropping everything. I keep fucking dropping everything. Anyway. I've been using the shit, ever living shit, out of the third bottle of my cherry vanilla body spray from Bath and Body Works, and it smells so good, and I love it, and I wish they didn't discontinue it, but sometimes you can find it at their semi-endless sale, so keep a lookout. And, yeah. Another thing from Bath and Body Works, because I really like their sprays. I like Victoria's Secret sprays, too, and I like other perfumes. But, yeah, the main places I go are Victoria's Secret and Bath and Body Works. But for fragrance, more than likely, I'm in Bath and Body Works buying the hell out of everything, because I can get coupons and all kinds of shit for there. And this one's Warm Harvest Apple, which is one of their fall scents from last year. In the 3-ounce mini bottle, and you can see that there's barely anything left. Sparkling Berry Bliss was my favorite out of the three or four fall scents last year. Despite Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin, that's always one of my top ones, fall scents anyway, which is sitting over there that I'm using currently, so that'll probably be in next month's favorites, or this month's favorites, at the beginning of next month. Yeah, after Halloween, I'm probably gonna do a video, but hopefully I won't bitch out this year, because last year I dated this big fucking douchebag that took up the majority of my time, so I really didn't have time to, make the Halloween makeup tutorial things like I was going to. I was going to, film with my actual camera, so it was a little bit better quality anyway, on how exactly that this goes from my face to someone else's face. And, because I wanted to do a Nicki Minaj look, I don't know how the fuck I'm going to do that, but I'm going to need money to do that first, so I have to get paid first, so whether it's before or after Halloween, hopefully before, I really hope it's before, depending on just my schedule and everything, and when I'll have time to do things. So, I don't know. Hopefully I'll have time to do more shit, so I'll be able to actually do tutorials this year and not get blocked out by some douchebag who thinks he's a werewolf. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, I'll rant about that some other fucking time, probably in one of my monster time, yeah, or I'll probably call it, like, monster rage or something, or energy rage. Any energy rage series. That's probably what I'll end up calling it. If I come up with something better, then I'll change the name. But as it stands right now, probably energy rage, depending on what energy drink that I have, because I might not always have monsters. So. And plus, coffee's caffeine, so if I drink coffee, it'll work, because coffee gives you energy, because it's caffeine. And da 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 da. I'm talking too much. Anyway, no apologies. I'm constantly fucking with my arms, so I apologize if I look like fucking Broby from Yo Gabba Gabba fucking swinging my arms around like a dipstick. Anyway. One of the ones that I actually got this from Walgreens, a coupon, dollar off coupon that came in a Sunday at a Smart Source ad paper thing. 49 cents at Walgreens. Dollar off coupon, because it was on sale for $1.49, they're usually $1.99. And I'm talking too much again. Calm myself down. And it's a Wet n Wild Megalass Salon Nail Color. And it's 0.45 fluid ounces. And it's so big. It's a pretty decent size for Wet n Wild. And this one is in 218A. I need a refresh dash mint. Very pretty color. It's kind of like a robin's egg shell blue, light, really light pale blue color. Very nice. I like it. It has really good lasting power. It lasts about probably 6 to 7 days, depending on if you use a top coat or not. I sometimes don't use a top coat or forget to put it on, and it's too late, and I don't feel like messing with it, and it'll chip, but it's Wet n Wild. All nail polishes will chip, inevitably, no matter if you have OPI, Simple Colors, Orly, China Glaze, Essie, whatever the fuck. It will chip, okay? It's really, it's all depending on how fast you want it to chip, I guess. But they all have pretty much similar qualities, so, I mean, don't really matter either way what nail polish you get. Because I seriously have 12 of the dollar nail polishes that, or 99 cent nail polishes that Wet n Wild makes. And those are the fucking, what do they call them? The Wild Shine nail colors. Because they're 99 cents. They have a variety of colors, especially if you go to either Ulta, Kmart, or anywhere that sells Wet n Wild, Walmart, wherever. They will have a decent selection of colors in any Wet n Wild nail polish. And they're really, really, really cheap and affordable. It's nuts. But anyway. On to another one, which is actually, ironically, one of the, what, Wild, I just fucking looked at it, I'm dumb. Well, the front rubbed off this one, so it's kind of useless staring at it, but, it's a Wet n Wild Wild Shine Nail Color in Lavender Pearlescent. I have used quite a bit of it, because of it being nail polish, and, you know, you don't use it all the time, but most of the time, and I'm consistently fucking switching colors and fucking around with different things and whatnot and ways to do things. Anyway, really pretty pink. This is probably one of my favorite pinks that I own, next to Lady Luck. Lady Luck is a little bit darker and less shimmery. It's more of a matte color, just with shine. It's a matte color with shine. I just applauded my stupidity. Anyway, I have Orly nail polish. Or Orly Nail Lacquer. Lacquer. In, the fuck? Twilight. That kind of ruined it for me, but it's good nail polish. I use this as a top coat. It has slight flecks of shimmer in it. Not glitter. Glitter is all chunky and thick and whatever. Like what's on my nails. That's chunky and thick glitter. That is shimmer. Very light shimmer, and it's actually not, it looks like it would be light blue, but it's definitely not. It's really just, it's like clear, just with like little, tiny, little grained up specks of shimmer in it. Anyway, and next nail polish is a Rimmel 30, I'm looking right at it and I said 30, it's a 60 second Rimmel London nail polish, and number 615, Night Before. Ooh. Pregnancy nail polish. Anyway, it's a really pretty purple color. I love it. It almost looks black in certain lights, but it's definitely purple, I promise. You can kind of see how it looks. It's got that weird gold shimmer in it, next to it being, you know, really pretty sparkly purple. Anyway, I have a Pure Ice one that you can get from Walmart for however much. I think the tag fucking disappeared off of it. But anyway, it's jet. That's the only fucking jet black nail polish that Pure Ice makes. So, I don't know. I've been using that as a thumbnail shade. Here's a Maybelline Color Show Nail Lacquer in a Pink Shock number 200. I've used a shit ton of it because it's very good and it's actually pretty long lasting. I mean, like I said, regardless, all nail polish will chip. And you can see my hamster being a scumbag in the background. Scumbag McLovin. Mr. Lovin, what are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? You're so cute. He's so cute when he does his McLovin thing. I'm just gonna stay like this so you can see him be a douchebag in the background while I talk. Anyway, the last two are Simple Colors ones. One is a Simple Colors nail polish in Secret Admirer number 933. It's a very black, glittery color. And yes, it's glittery. Because it's a little bit more of a coarse, glittery, whatever. See, come on. Disappeared. Anyway. The next Simple Colors nail polish is Midnight Blue, which I got for Christmas. It's in my Christmas video from Christmas 2011. And it's number 105. And I got these at Walgreens, and they were... One of them was 99 cents, the other one I got for Christmas. It was probably on sale, and that's probably why my grandma bought it. But anyway, I digress. I'm thinking that I should get McLovin before I go. McLovin, come here! McLovin, come here, bro! Come here. Get on my hand. Oh, hello. Oh, hello, McLovin. Hello. Hi, butt cheek. There is my hand. Cold steel, bro. There is McLovin doing his Mick thing. Because he's a McHamster and that's what he does. McLovin, hold still. I'm not going to drop you in my coffee. You need to hold on. Anyway, there's McLovin doing his hyperactive thing because he's a nocturnal little bastard. But I love him so much. Love him very dearly. Say I love you, Mr. Levin. Yes, I do. Do you want to say bye to anybody that watches this video? Say bye, Mr. Levin. Bye. Well, anyway, McLovin says bye. I say bye. I might make another video after this entitled one of the first energy rage things. Or energy talks. Probably energy talk is gonna be the title of it, and it's just gonna be where I ramble on about things. So if you're interested in watching that, that should be my most recent video besides this one. And yeah, feel free to watch it and fucking video response it. I don't give a shit. Comment. I don't care. You don't have to. You don't want to. But. I do these videos because I like to do them, not because anybody wants me to. A few times that I get requests, that's cool. I like when I get requests because I'm like, oh, requests, people care. And then I'm like, oh. Sad face. Anyway, I have McLovin climbing all over me. He's jumping everywhere, being a crazy Mr. Lovin. Why are you so crazy? Why are you so crazy? You're so crazy, McLovin. No, you're so cute. No, you're so cute. What are you doing? No, you're so cute. There's McLovin. Last look at McLovin. Even though he won't hold still. That's why I kind of have to hold him still. But I really don't even hold him that still. I just make sure he's propped up. He just kind of does the wiggling and whatnot. And gets free so he can roam. Anyway. We go, and if you're interested in watching, go ahead. If you're not, it won't hurt my feelings. Just look out for more videos like this then, if that's the videos you prefer. Yeah, so I'm gonna go, and I will see you guys later.